Apart from changing the properties of the objects through layers, we can also change the properties of an object individually. In the following drawing, the section of a mechanical component has been created in advance. As you can see, the necessary dimensions have also been created. Since this drawing is representing the section of an object, a hatch has also been inserted. In this lesson, we will see how we can change the properties of some certain objects as we see fit. Firstly, I will change the color of the dimensions. To select all the dimensions easily, I am going to hide all the other layers except the dimensions layer. To do that, I will open the layers list from the layer panel of the home ribbon and click on the light bulb of its layer. Once I click on the light bulb icon of the zero layer, a message appears to inform me that the current layer will be turned off. In this case, I do not mind because I do not intend to draw anything, so I will click on the turn the current layer off option. Now that only the dimensions are visible, I will select them all using the window method. Then, I will expand the first list in the Properties panel of the Home ribbon, which has to do with the object's color, and select a light blue color. I will press Escape, and notice that the color has changed. At this point, I will turn on the zero layer in which the main object was created, and I will also turn off the Dimensions layer. This time, I will increase the width of the object's lines, so I will select them all with the window method. Next, I will expand the second list in the Properties panel of the Home ribbon, which represents the line weight, and select the 0.30mm option. I will press Escape to unselect everything, but notice that nothing seems to have changed. The reason this happened is because the default setting in AutoCAD is to not show the line weights. To change that, I will click on the customization icon in the lower right corner and check the line weight option. The icon now appears in the status bar, but it is not active. Once I click on it, it becomes a lighter shade of blue, which means that it's active. Notice that now the line weight is visible. At this point, I will turn on the center lines layer. The lines that indicate the center of the circles are shown, however, they are just continuous lines and not centered lines as they should be. To fix that, I need to change the line type of these lines. Before I select anything, I will expand the third list in the Properties panel of the Home ribbon to see if the line type I want is loaded in the drawing. As you can see, the only type of line that is available in the list is the continuous line. That means that I have to load a centered line in the drawing, hence, I will click on the other option. The Line Type Manager window with all the loaded line types appears. I will click on the Load button, and from the new window that appears, I will search for the centered line type. Once I find it, I will select it and click OK. Now, the center line is added to the list of the Line Type Manager window. I will click OK to close this window too, and now I will carefully select the lines I wish to be center lines. I will expand the third list in the Properties panel of the Home ribbon again, and I will select the center type. Even though the line type changed, notice that no change is visible in the drawing. The line type scale is to blame for this result. So I need to select them again. Once I have selected them, I will right-click somewhere in the drawing area, and from the menu that appears, I will select the Properties option. In this way, the Properties palette opens. In this palette, we can find and modify several interesting properties of the selected objects. However, in this lesson, we won't elaborate on all the properties that are included in this palette. The only one that I'm interested in at the moment is the line type scale, which is currently set to 1. I will change the value of this field to 0.25 and press Enter. Notice that the center lines changed and their pattern is now visible. I should mention that sometimes you may have to experiment quite a bit before you find the appropriate scale value. At this point, I will close the Properties palette, and while those lines are still selected, I will expand the Properties panel. As you can see, I can also add transparency to the selected objects. In the Value field, next to the word Transparency, I will type the number 50 and I will press Enter. Then, I will press Escape to see the result clearly. Before we finish the lesson, I will show you how we can match the properties of two objects. To get a clearer picture of what I mean, let's say I want the two lines of the rectangle to have the same properties as the lines that indicate the circle's centers. Instead of selecting them and change their type and the transparency value, I will click on the Match Properties button, which can be found in the Properties panel of the Home ribbon. As soon as the tool is active, a message prompts me to select the source objects whose properties I wish to copy. So I will select one of the center lines. Then, I have to select the destination objects, namely, the objects I wish to have the same properties with the source object. I will click on the vertical line first, and then on the horizontal one. Notice that their appearance changed automatically. Once I'm done, I will press Escape to deactivate the command. Finally, I will turn back on all the layers that I hid to see the final result of the drawing. It's important to mention that by changing those properties, we override the properties we have set in layers.